Right now, to join us on A Corporate Radar, we've got N.H. Bhansali, the CEO of Emami Group. Thanks, Mr. Bhansali, for joining us, and a very good morning. We've seen substantial decline in menthol prices on a year-on-year basis, coupled with the fact that Emami has undertaken some price increases. Could you walk us through what impact or benefit this will have on the margins of Emami, perhaps in the coming quarter, and even in general, your margin guidance for FY14?
See, we expect this year and particularly the quarter also the margins to improve. See, gross margins has to improve. In fact, if you look at since last 2 years, the prices were increasing, and you were mentioning about menthol, it had also increased substantially. And if you look at petro products and also the packaging materials, that had also increased substantially. So, but from the last quarter itself, the prices had started easing, and there had been an impact in COGS last quarter itself. We expect this to continue in the current year also. So there would be some margin expansion then on COGS. But of late, because of the increase in the prices of rupee depreciation, there could be some impact on packaging material. But despite this, there would be some margin expansion there.
So net at the end of the first quarter, I mean, if you combined all the factors that Reema referred to in terms of raw material prices and rupee depreciation, will your margins remain unchanged, or are you still likely to get some elbow room to expand, or will it fall?
Yes, it should improve. Okay. It should improve.
Okay. Yeah. You have any idea, 1 percentage point, 2 percentage points, how much might the elbow room be?
Difficult to guess, because we have a lot still 3 quarters to come in, so
it's difficult to guess,
but I feel that
I meant the first half actually.
First half, I mean because the prices are very volatile, the rupee itself is so volatile, it's difficult to guess, but even considering this kind of volatility, one can expect still margin to improve.
Okay. Mr. Bhansali, last quarter we had seen degrowth in your international business. It had fallen by about 12-13%. How is this quarter shaped up in terms of the international business? What's the, is there going to be revenue growth? If yes, to what extent?
See, international business, as we interacted last time also, that we were in the process of consolidation. We had taken some of the correctional steps also, and from this quarter itself, the things have started improving, and the results are coming in. We expect a growth in this fiscal on international business, and in this quarter as well, some growth would come.
Okay. In general, sir, what would your guidance be on the revenue front for FY14? You closed up FY13 with a growth of about 17% on your top line. Is FY14 going to be better than FY13?
We expect the same kind of growth to continue. Last year had been a good growth for us. It was driven by volume growth, volume and value growth both. And this year also we expect a good volume value growth in the same kind as it was in the last year. So good growth can be expected.
Okay. Do you have any foreign loans at all?
No. On net to net, there are some very marginal loans, but on net to net, we have a liquid assets. We have cash on the balance sheet. So there is net to net, there is no loan as such. There is huge liquidity available in the balance sheet.
So you've already taken about.
So there is no impact as such of the financial.
Okay.
There is no impact as such of the foreign exchange there. Sorry. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So, shifting focus, you've already undertaken a price increase for your summer portfolio. Could we expect a further increase in the summer portfolio for the price increase, or perhaps you might increase it for the winter portfolio? Could you provide us an outlook?
We are expecting around 4-5% of the price rise this year, taking care of the inflation and all. But as I said, the markets are so volatile, you need to review it maybe after 3-4 months or so. So as on that, we expect around 4-5% kind of price rise for the financial year.
Okay. What is the cash and debt on your books?
It's around 300 crore.
What? Cash or debt?
Free
cash.
Yeah, net cash on the balance sheet.
Okay, yeah. And what's the size of the debt?
Size of the debt is very less. In fact, around because it's after adjusting for the loans itself, I said that the net debt would be at around 300 crore.
Fair. No, I'm asking because
net cash would be of around 300 crore.
Okay, I'm asking you because does it mean that we expect you to look around for any acquisition? Is there something on your radar? Should we expect something in the first half of the year itself?
Yeah, we are always on the lookout for the acquisitions. You might have come across through the newspaper, through the media as well. But we are looking at acquisitions which can add values to us. We had done our acquisition of Zandu in domestic market, and we are always on the lookout of acquisition which should add value to us.
And just a last question from my side: has there been any, is growth back on the canteen store department side, because that was under pressure in FY13? So what is the outlook for FY14 on the CSD side?
It has started improving. In fact, the growth has come back. It's in line with our expectations. So far as our forecasts are concerned, it's in line with what we had projected. So we expect that the CSD things are now stabilizing.
What will you spend for advertisements in the current year?
Would be in the same kind of level, at around 16-17% or so. Because it also depends on the kind of launches which we do, launches and relaunches, and also the emphasis we put on our power brands.
Okay.
So it would remain at around the same level as it was in the last year. It may increase a little as well.
Mm-hmm. Any new launches?
We have recently relaunched Fair and Handsome with 360-degree advertisement there. We are reinforcing our media plan, media insertions there. So, and all our brands are doing extremely well, and the penetration levels are so low. So the existing brands are also, we are putting lot of thrust there on advertisement and media. And the new launches also we have done in healthcare division, and some of the new launches are expected to come in the latter part of this year as well.
All right, we'll leave it at that. Thank you very much, Mr. Bansali, for joining us with your thoughts. So that's an FMCG company saying that they are positive on the kind of revenue growth as well as margins that they will be able to produce in the current year.